will do nothing, Amelisan, but accept your fate. The time that was mentioned has come, Bad Child. There is a choice before you. You have prevailed against all that have assailed you, and now you must decide your fate. Spawn of the dead god remains, the sibling who fought at your side. Her portion of the essence is not large, but she must make a choice. So it is done. The only decision that remains then belongs to your sibling. The vast majority of the soul essences of the children of Baal, Lord of Murder, now belong to you and you alone. You must now decide what to do with this power. Be wise. The choice is irrevocable. Choose to surrender that portion of the essence which remains with you. It shall be given to Amelisan, and her soul, with all the essence it contains, shall be destroyed. Surrendering the essence will allow the gods to remove its evil taint and hide it well within the halls of Mount Celestia, forever preventing it from soiling further souls. You, Baalspawn, would be made immortal, free to continue your life with a destiny of your own choosing. The manipulations of gods will no longer be a concern, and your soul will be untainted. Once Amelisan's soul is destroyed and the essence released, you may accept it into yourself if you want it, and the throne of Baal will be yours to command. You have fought against the taint of your father with great vigilance. It is most impressive. Impressive enough that I would be willing to remain by your side. The power you may claim will bring new enemies, and the attentions of evil gods such as Sirik, who usurped your sire's godly role by the Edict of Al the Overfather. I will fight by your side and help you achieve whatever destiny awaits in the plains. Your future is unknown even to the gods, although it will certainly be a great one. Choice is difficult, but these are your two options, Baalspawn. This is where your destiny is realized, and your future begins.
Ha ha! At last the time has come. Fulfill your destiny. Become the new God of Murder, and usher in a new age of chaos and destruction.
What? Why are you looking at me? Take the power already. Isn't that what you came here for?
I didn't follow the
this insufferable monkey around to see all its dignity lost, what would I get out of that?
So, it's finally come down to this, has it? After all we've been through, right, with Candlekeep and Baldur's Gate, through Irenicus and Bodhi and their plans, I wonder what Garion would say now.
My promise to Garion is at last at an end. It would be difficult to watch you move on to a higher state of being, if that is where you choose to go. But you hardly need my guidance any longer.
The opportunity to grasp your birthright, to take up the reins of power as they are meant to be.
The time has come to make your choice, Valspar. What is your wish? Then you shall begin life anew, mortal, without the taint of your sire upon your soul, and the essence of Baal shall forever be hidden. You have done well, and freedom shall be your reward. So you're going to stay immortal? Wow, after all that, we're going to end up on the road again. Must feel good, though, to have your own future ahead of you again, though, no? Your decision has been made, Godchild. Now the act must be carried out. Prepare yourself.
Divine essence slowly fades, and for a moment you feel empty, incomplete. It is frightening, but soon yields to a new sensation, one of hope. With your closest companions at your side, you are free to live out your mortal life, no longer a pawn of Baal's prophecy. The adventure draws to a close, but there will be more to come. Even as a mortal, you are to be looked upon in awe, and your power commands attention, both friendly and otherwise. Your life is yours, as are the trials to come. As years pass, tales of your exploits shall spread far and wide, and bards will sing your name along with heroes and villains of legend. Your life may be mortal, your time now finite, but the mark you have left upon the realms will endure.